Hello and welcome to a new video. I am now on my way to pick up my new car. It's not the Focus replacement, it's more like an addition to the fleet. So don't worry, there will be plenty of more Focus content coming in the next few weeks and months. So what's so special about this car? Well, it's a new project. It's a car that still has MOT, so it's perfectly drivable. I'm going to drive it on my way back home. But it has one very interesting thing. It has absolutely mega miles. Now, I'm going to pop on the train and then we'll see you in just a moment.
Well, and here it is, the high mileage Volvo that I've purchased yesterday and I drove back home after I bought it. The trip was an absolute breeze. It was very comfortable. It was trouble-free as well. Well, it has been properly maintained, the car, so I wouldn't expect any less, even though it has an astonishing amount of miles in it. Some of you might know this car already, as it has been the subject of a few magazine articles on the internet and so on. And I purchased this car from Kelsey Media yesterday, and I dealt with a lovely chap called Joe Miller. He is one of the members of the Kelsey Media team who published the advert just a week ago, actually. And then when I saw the car advertised, I thought, I gotta have it. I wasn't initially looking for a Volvo S80, never mind a project car as such. I was actually in search of something completely different, but I saw this one and I thought, that car deserves really some love. So, how many miles do you think this car has? Some of you already know this car, so already knows how many miles does it have. So, let's go inside and I'm gonna show you how many it does have.
Getting into this lovely leather interior, although it is a little bit tired because, well, it has 20 years under its belt, but more so the mileage that you are about to see. Are you ready? 718,254 miles, basically nearly 29 times around the earth, and probably went to the moon back, and it's almost getting there. It's pretty amazing how many miles this car has done. It's not the Volvo with the highest mileage in the country. At the moment it ranks on the top three, in third or fourth place, I think. And it is, according to the official Volvo High Mileage Club, number 10 in the world. So it is pretty amazing how many miles this car has done. And it is a testament of quality of these cars.
Impressed? Well, I certainly am, really, with the amount of miles that this car has done. And it's still here, standing on its four wheels, proud, but in need of some love. So let's have a look at the condition of the car, starting from the exterior.
Okay, so starting here from the front, we can see that, well, it's just the usual scrapes, the usual sun chips, but overall, it's actually not that terrible. One thing in here that we'll have to replace soon will be the front grille, because as you can see in here, it is actually quite loose. Of course, with the age, the black plastics do fade, and also the towing eye cover is missing as well, so that will need to be replaced. The headlights, they are made of glass, which is a good thing. They don't need to be polished. But one thing that I've noticed when I took the car for a wash yesterday is that there is some condensation. So probably the seals have gone on both of them and will need to be addressed soon. The bumper also is a little bit loose, probably a broken clip or something. And that's about it. Here, the wing, there is some bubbling on the wheel arch, a couple of dents in here. And if we walk across here, the side, there's things growing in it. It's quite green, plastic faded, which is also expected. This, several car washes and so on, perform a bit of a wear in this area on the mirror, and of course usual scrapes, parking things. And this is probably the worst bit of the car. There is a couple of holes. This was apparently shown on the MOT, which was in August last year, but I'm gonna get that addressed before the MOT really. It's welding and bodywork is not my speciality, but it has to be addressed. Bit of bubbling here as expected, and the rear bumper is also being fixed with this Phillips screw in here. Of course it just probably will need the actually it will need the full respray, but I'm not going to do that because I really don't have the funds for it. But I'm going to try to do and smarten up, try to remove some scratches, some scuffs, and also do a deep exterior detailing, especially more like cleaning rather than actually polishing and so on. Basically just getting rid of this old accumulated dirt that you see in here on the gutters and the rubbers and so on. Just give a very thorough clean, which is something that I'm actually looking forward to. The plastics again faded, but this can be easily sorted, and there's some bubbling as well here in this area, which probably can be DIY'd, I would assume. Bumper as well, a bit scruffy, but and this bit, which I just found out, I'm not sure if this is aluminium or plastic. Not entirely sure. So the Volvo specialists, my viewers, will be able to tell me. Headlights, no problem at all in there. Bit of a scuff there as well, expected. Not too bad in there, nothing too. And then a bit more rust on this area here, which also need to be addressed. I assume that the car will probably need both seals, but they would tell me later. In here, this is looks like it's plastic and it's bubbling, unless it's like anodized aluminium. No, it's plastic, it's bubbling. It's really weird actually. And it's a bit more in here. That's strange. Never seen a thing like it. And of course the gutters also need deep cleaning as well. I need to find a door trim as well, because the chrome strip is missing compared to this one. Nothing to see there, and just a little bit of rust as well. But it's something that I can live on, really. And actually, this car has been really oiled quite a lot. But I suppose that with the amount of times that these doors have been open and closed, because this car was usually a chauffeur service, explains why the doors would have to be kept in tip-top condition. In here, again, the plastic has some bubbling, which I find a bit strange as well. The screen is a replacement one. It says the REC, and the wipers don't seem to be too bad of shape either. Surprised that this has actually three windscreen nozzles. That one is coming off, but surely that's an easy fix. And again, some other scratches and some wheel arch bubbling. Okay, so that is the condition of the bodywork as expected. It is a little bit scruffy, but nothing that can be done. The most serious bit is, of course, the hole on the wheel arch that will have to be addressed before the MOT. But hopefully there will be a solution that won't be too expensive.
In regards to wheels and tires, well, it is expected that they will need to be replaced at some point. It has been noted on the MOT advisory that there is some slight cracking on both tires, especially at the rear, but it will be something that will be due, it will be done in due course. The wheels could do with a refurb as well, but then again, that is the least of my worries, really. That will be one of the last things probably to be done in this car, as things like the mechanical bits are the most important, and that's the ones that we're going to look into right now.
gas struts that actually do work. So here it is, the mighty five-cylinder Audi unit, 2.5 liters, single cam turbo diesel engine, which is known for its reliability. This engine looks like it has had a recent service. The oil and the filter look quite fresh, so I'm not going to replace it as yet. There is quite a bit of oil leak in general, either from the steering pump area, the steering power steering reservoir, and also what looks like historical oil leaks, basically from the countless oil changes that this car had during its life. There will be some spillage, and which they all accumulate. So let's have a look at the more detail into the engine. So everything seems to be in pretty running order. The car has had a recent replacement alternator, and when I look at the service history, this car seemed to have a particular appetite for alternators. It has had quite a few in its life. There is some yellow electric cable just going around here, which I found it just a bit weird, but again, it could be also a normal thing. But there's quite a bit of a weaving in this area here, which is where it's located, the power steering reservoir. In terms of maintenance, the first thing that I will be doing in this car will be to replace the cam belt and the diesel pump belt. And I'm gonna get a Volvo dealer to do this. And that's for a very good reason. First, I never changed the cam belt in the car before, and I certainly wouldn't want to have my first attempt in this car. And also, the diesel timing belt, the diesel pump timing belt, needs to be done by a professional, simply because it needs a dynamic timing where you need a special Volvo software in order to make sure that the timing between the diesel pump and the cam is correct. You need specialist equipment for that, which I don't have, so I don't want to do it at home. Basically, because I've never done a cam belt change before, asking me to do in one of these is almost like asking me to build the Burj Khalifa when I barely done a gingerbread house before, really. So rather have someone professional to do that kind of job. In terms of the rest, everything seems to be working. There's no lights on the dashboard, so I'm pretty pleased with it. The engine starts first time every time. It pulls really well, and let's go and try and hear it for the first time. When it comes to brakes and suspension, these are the kind of items that are usually mentioned on the MOT reports. And it has been mentioned that these discs are actually quite, there's a bit of corrosion in them, which it's something that I could easily do anyway. So, and the same for the other side. It's quite dark in here, but I'm sure you're able to. There you go. This is actually the same on the other side, so these will definitely need to be replaced soon. Suspension. There are a couple of knocks that I do notice sometimes when driving. By the way, the front brakes are absolutely fine. There seem no issue with them. They have been replaced only a few thousand miles ago, so nothing needs to be done in them. With the suspension, I do notice that there is a bit of a knock, which looks like it's coming from the front. I thought it could be the front top bearings, but it looks like that they have been replaced. But there are a couple of bushes on the top of them, which they look quite old. They might need to be replacing. But then again, it's something that I will have to look into more detail at a later stage. So this is just a preliminary analysis of the car, really. And I think there's nothing else that needs to be looked at in terms of mechanical side. Of course, the exhaust is not in bad condition, actually. There's no holes or blowing or anything like that. And the underside of the car, it's actually in better condition than my Jag was. To be honest, the Jag was 4 years older, but then the Jag is typically more prone to rust anyway. It's just really the seals that will need attention. And here it is, the proud high mileage badge. Nice. Okay, now let's look at the interior. The interior is used as you would expect, and for nearly 720,000 miles, it's actually in better condition compared to some of the cars that I drove that had less than half the mileage of this car. And of course, the steering wheel, the leather, is pretty much gone on top of here, so that would need to be either recovered or get a good quality second hand. But all the controls, they are just as tight as anything. It's just all the buttons and so on, everything just works so well. It is just really unbelievable. In regards to the leather seats, of course, they will need to be refurbished. These are not the original leather seats. Apparently, they have been replaced when this car was about 5 years old. But nevertheless, these seats have at least something like 300,000 miles or something like that. I have to look up on that into more detail anyway. But there are no cracks on the leather. It's just a bit of a scuff in here, and a bit of minor, but no splits, no tears or anything like that. So I think they could actually be easily restored. It has all the carpets except for the driver's side, so I would need to get original driver's overmat. But apart from that, everything seems to be actually in very good condition. But let's look into more detail at the rest of the interior. So here's the scuff on the driver's side. Yeah, it needs to be repainting, but all this area, it's actually not too bad. And you can hear, actually you can see here, the leather splitting, so this will need to be recovered. I'm not going to use one of those Halford type of covers. I think they're absolutely hideous. But here, this bit here probably needs to be put back in. Probably I'll just get another one, to be fair. But everything else seems to be in pretty good nick, actually. Now, in here, this is the thing with the brake. Look at the travel of the handbrake. Whoa, what a big leverage there this has. And this needs to be replaced. It's all frayed and peeling and so on. And same with the handbrake gaiter as well. It has an aftermarket stereo, which works really well. I've tried everything and so on. But I'm a bit in two minds whether to put the original Volvo radio in here a top end unit. I think it's the HS01 or HU01 or something like that. And might just look into that, but I don't know. There are more important things to do, really. And here, actually, everything looks all right. Well, amazing, it doesn't have a mirror on the driver's side. Not that I need one, actually, but... And has some lights in there. Nice, something that the wife absolutely loves in cars like these. The mirror with the lights. And plenty of cutsy lights as well. The gear knob is actually not in bad shape, although there's a bit that's in there that looks like it has been chewed on. But never mind. The passenger seat is in really good condition, and this isn't too bad. Here's the manual. Oh, what's that? Ah, I'll look into that next time. There's a light or something like that. Oh, these are stops. Don't know what are those, really. Or maybe just the stops of this. Actually, everything seems to be in pretty good shape considering the amount of miles and the amount of use this car has. Probably this one just needs a light refurb. There you go here. To put your CDs. Nice one. And this... oops. Here's what looks like a cup holder. That's a cup holder. How revealing. There you go. And good place to put my driving glasses. Yes, because I'm blind as a bat. Not. Okay. Now let's look at the rear seats where they have seen quite a lot of action. Not that kind of action, I must say. But because this car was used for chauffeur services, a lot of bums would have sat in here. And I'm quite pleased to see that they are the original Volvo overmats in here. What's this? Okay. Oh, no smokers in here. Good. And... everything seems to be so solid. It's just unbelievable. It's really, really good. Put some cutsy lights in here. Oh, never found these had. I reckon these seats could do with actually with a very good clean and feed. Let's look at the armrest. That's all right. Good stuff. The head lining, though. It will need a very deep cleaning. As you can see in here, it is actually grey. Oh, more cutsy lights in there. There's a couple of bits that have been nipped in there. I might just try to do a clean of the headlining, see if there's any chances of doing a good clean on it. But I needed to get another piece of trim for the seat belt. That one's still in there, and I just forgot that pillar, the cloth from the A pillar is actually splitting, so that needs to be glued back in or put new cloth. Whips system, yeah, here it just needs probably just either glued back, but I might just get really new cloth and put in here. I think that's it from the interior. And the seats are very comfortable. Even the driver one, which is the one the most used, it felt so nice and refreshing. Very, very comfortable drive it was yesterday. Now, let's look at the boot. And... well, not really much to report here. What the hell is that? Is that a side mark or something? Does that belong to... Oh, it's a side marker. It's a second-hand unit. Okay, I'll look into that. Oh, damn it. Okay, it looks like a blower motor with the resistor, and that's the injection pump kit that came with the car. But since I'm going to take the car to a Volvo dealer, I don't think I will need it. Pull parallel to the floor. Okay, I need to read the manual, because to be honest, the tab to pull the fuel cap, good. Yeah, this will need a thorough detailing. Nice. Something loose inside that will need to be addressed at some point. So, how is it like to drive? Well, let's go and find out. Well, that's the other thing that needs to be addressed, and it is the seatbelt, which is frayed on the side here, and that has been MOT advisory as well. Sliding gears is not a problem, although there's a slight play on the gear shift, but probably something that has to do with replacing a couple of bushes or something like that. But no problem, the sliding gears, it's absolutely fine. Off. So this engine, the 5-cylinder diesel Audi unit, it sounds a little bit agricultural for today's standards. Let's face it, this when the Volvo S80 was launched at the end of 1998, I think, the diesel engine that they had available was from Audi. It's not the first time that Volvo used Audi engines on their range. It's something that come up since the 1970s or 1980s, using the 5-cylinder Audi units, which were available also on the Audi 100. But by the time Volvo launched the S80 with the old single cam Audi unit, the Volkswagen Group had already moved on with their very famous TDI engines. So it wasn't until later that Volvo, I think it was with the facelift, no, I think 2002, that they launched a newer diesel engine, the D5. So driving it, I noticed just a couple of slight knocks. As you can see here, there you go. It might be just a few bushes that need to be replacing. Actually, there is an MOT advisory regarding one of the front bushes that need to be replaced because there's some play on it. And so that will be something that will be addressed. The engine is nice and torquey, and it does pull well. It's not really fast for today's standards, but that's not really the point of this. It's just it's still a usable daily driver with a decent fuel economy, actually. And now I'm going to pull into the dual carriageway. And the car just cruises perfectly on the dual carriageway. The noise in the cabin is actually very good. It's not too loud, to be honest, compared to my Focus, which is actually quite loud, but hopefully it will actually even better when the suspension bits are sorted out, as well as getting new tires. But it's comfortable, like, these chairs are absolutely amazing. You just don't feel nothing. It's just after an hour and a half trip back home, I felt as fresh as a lettuce. I know people in the UK say it's fresh as a daisy, but that's the term that we use in Portugal, fresh as a lettuce. Don't ask me why.
most amazing thing is that everything works in this car. All four windows work. There's no lights on the dash. The aircon seems to be working, although it's too cold to really test the freezing power of the aircon. The heating works very well, although sometimes it's a little bit fizzly. It does work, but sometimes just I think that some contacts need to be a bit clean. But it does work nevertheless. The radio works. The cruise control works. Everything works in this car. It's absolutely amazing, and it's just a really the testament that if you look after a car, it will look after you, unless the car is an absolute piece of rubbish, crappily built, and then there's not much chances if you don't, even if you look after it. Yeah, I'm very happy with this car. Yeah, the engine is smooth. It has that typical vibration, of course, with 720,000 miles. I'm actually impressed. It drives really well, it pulls well, it goes into gears with no effort whatsoever. In essence, it's a car that despite the mileage, it does the job. I said earlier that the wipers are in good condition. Well, they're not too bad, but I think I might have to replace the windscreen at some point because I can't see absolutely bug all with all of those miles and with all the debris and the dirt from driving. It really has an effect on the windscreen. It's almost becomes etched. Oh, here's another fellow Volvo owner with a 2.4 V70. Not bad. I bet he doesn't have as many miles as this one. Who knows? In terms of fuel economy, it's a bit hard to tell because either I'm being completely dumb or I cannot find a trip computer. There is this info panel and this null wheel on the indicator stalk, but I don't seem to find a trip computer where it tells the number or the mileage and the number of miles left in the tank. I still haven't found that out, how to do it, but if any of my viewers that are Volvo experts, please drop a comment on the comment section. And the handling, well, it's actually not too bad. It's not as sharp as the Focus, for example, but to be honest, that's not really the purpose of this car, really. The S80 was built as a big, comfortable motorway cruiser to dash an executive in a hurry in comfort. So it's not really the typical car that he will take on the typical country lanes for a quick blast before your day in the office. But it's a lovely car to drive, and they are just as good as I remember when I last drove them. God, it's been 20 years already. Well, how time flies.
And there you are. You've seen now the exterior condition of the car, the interior, the mechanical condition, and also how it drives. You're probably asking, what is the plan for this car? Basically, it's to keep driving it. There are some things that, which I'm gonna give immediate attention, and that's the cam belt, diesel pump belt, and the tensioners and idlers and auxiliary belts. All that needs to be done, and as I explained before, that will be done by a Volvo dealership. Then I'm going to look at other bits, electrical stuff. I'm going to look at the brake, suspension, and tires. That will be my next port of call after the engine. And the problems with the sills, that will be done before the MOT. I don't really have to do that now. Cosmetics, well, they are probably the last things to be done in this car. The scarves and so on. I'm going to do an exterior wash, a very thorough one. I'm gonna try to make it look a little bit better. Of course, there are some things that are beyond my capabilities, some things that are irreparable, they need full respray, so I won't be doing that at this stage. In terms of the interior, probably the first thing that I'll be doing will be to replace the steering wheel. It is quite grubby to use at the moment. It is so worn, so that will be my very first thing that I will replace. But everything else is fine. I will do a deep interior clean, which will be on a future video as well. So that's it. I'd like to take this car to at least 750,000 miles. Would I like to take it to 1,000,000? Yes, I would love to, of course, but according to my calculations, that will take me about 20 years to achieve that. But nevertheless, the main objective is to preserve this amazing car and just to keep running it. It really deserves, it doesn't really deserve to be retired. It deserves another chance, and I'm gonna give it. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Take care.